20th century.
20th.
The century before us.
Yeah. Okay.
Which most of us are born in that 20th century anyway.
Even if we can't remember it too much.
Yeah, but I'll bring you guys to a time where when you're a specific race and you're looked at and you're not really welcome because you are that that kind of error, especially when you're Japanese. So this piece is called Home, 1942. Go home, Jap. Go home where you belong and don't come back. Those were the last echoes I heard before leaving. Before the break of dawn and before my mother heard the night's news. I worked in my father's grocery store as a clerk, storing goods away. The local radio dazzled the afternoon with jazz until rock smashed through our windows. Go home, Jap, fucking Japs. We don't want you here. A police officer rushed into the store and fell to the ground when gunshots were heard fired nearby. 2 minutes passed by. No sound escaped. It was the end of a November afternoon and our family business had not earned much. In the evening, my father ate his dinner silently. My mother and sister made no sound. It was the last dinner I remember eating outside of sight. After that brief cold morning and my first step onto the dry northeast sand, all became silent. No more name calling, labels, or slogans. Just the sound of my breath, the ringing in the air, and the occasional gunshots heard at night when all are fast asleep. It is still the middle of December. Temperatures at night drop below 40, and I see my breath each night amid the light as I cram myself into the small corner. Each night I count myself to sleep, and sometimes I am awakened from a blast or an echo from my dreams. Other times I'm awakened from the hard shakes I cannot seem to shake off. When I wake up before daybreak, I watch the American flag wave freely against the white frosted mountain background in the middle of nowhere. Celebrate the Asian American Heritage Month.
Who wrote it?
Me.
You wrote that poem?
Yeah.